Good morning, students. Let's see the information of the lecture first. Class 9, subject English, and we are studying English grammar. So you all just need to be very much vigilant so that you can understand the points basically in a very correct manner. So students, today we'll study practice determiners, and this is lecture number 1. We just completed in the last class also, though there will be a little bit updation of or the rules, the extra which are used in the 9th and 10th standard will be shared or discussed with you people so that you can mark the correct sentences and can obtain the good marks there, right? What is a determiner? Basically, we need to see students. Now you see, determiners are words placed in front of a noun to make clear what the noun refers to. This you need to understand. Determiners are placed in front of a noun. Why it is placed in front of a noun? Because it refers to the noun. What is the noun and why it is here, right? These two questions are qualified, means ultimately we need to understand the word which qualifies the noun is called determiner, means determines or specifies the noun, right? That particular word is called a determiner. They all are put at the beginning of a noun or noun phrase, and usually we cannot use them as more than one determiner for the same noun or noun phrase in a sentence. So what we understand here, students, we need to see that the same determiner or more than one determiner for the same noun in the sentence cannot be used. We are not supposed to use the same determiner, like I say, this book is mine. Can we use this again in the same sentence? Not. Though the examiner might create a bit hassle or a bit confusion for the students, so you must be careful enough that the two determiners for the same noun in the single sentence cannot be used, and we don't use that. We need to determine so that we can justify the things, right? This will help us a lot as well as the students, right, everyone? Why it is? Because sometimes what happened, examiners put this in the sentence. We have found that examiners are making this so we just need to make sure it is not going to cut our marks, right? So see the further one. There are 8 classes of determiners that we need to see. 8 classes of determiners are there. Which are these? This can be taken as like there are 8 types of determiners. Let's see. The first one is articles. Articles like definite and indefinite articles. You must have studied articles are of 2 types. First one is a definite article, and the next one is indefinite article that we'll see in detail further. The next one is demonstrative determinants, then quantifiers. These quantifiers determinants which call like refers to the quality. The next one is possessive determinants. And when you go to the next, numerical determinants, these are cardinal and ordinal. These are divided in two categories, these numerical determinants, which we'll get further in detail. Then the next one is distributive, and then indefinite. These are the determinants like. Now let's just see what it starts with. Articles A, N, and the. In the starting, what we found, students, we found that we have three articles, A, N, and the. Now you need to see A, N are indefinite articles and the is definite article, right? Then we need to see this. The indefinite articles A or N signal that the reference is non-specific or general. So see students, you need to understand one thing. A and N are used indefinitely, means non-specific, or generally we can use for a particular noun. These are called indefinite article, and these come under the category of determinants, right? See the next one, as we get here, what we find, which is going to be very interesting with us. Definite article, the, signals that the reference is specific. When you talk about something very specific, there you can use the. The refers to the specific article, or you can say determiner basically. Right, so what we understand that the is used definitely, means where there is a reference of a specific noun, right, which is known by the both listener as well as the speaker, then there the is used to specify the reference. See the example, the visitors are coming means the one who's going to attend the visitors is also familiar that someone is going to visit. That's why the is used before visitors. Otherwise, some people can talk like this, visitors are coming. But when the is used, we are specifying that the listener or the attender, they are familiar, like they are going to have the visitors at their place. Now you see the next, a box of chocolate was eaten by Ravi. We are talking about some certain indefinite sort of thing, like that wasn't that much familiar before. So when the things are quite familiar with one another, we can quote it like these are used and known by the both speaker as well as by the listener. That we need to understand. Right, students, keep noting down the points. If you find like you want to have a discussion with after the class. So let's just practice in a detail. Use of indefinite article an. A is used before a noun beginning with a consonant sound. You need to see we do have two types of sounds. One of this consonant sound, and second one is vowel sounds. So what we need to understand, when there is a word, means noun starting with the consonant letter or consonant sound, letter we don't consider, we consider a sound actually. When it starts with the consonant, A is used, and when vowel is used, then N is used. You see a woman, a horse, a university. Here, woman, fruits, and university are words beginning with a consonant sound. So, see, students, some of the students take the vowel letters only. No, you need to take the sound specifically. When you take the sound specifically, then you become able to put the articles or like determiners in a proper way. That means you don't feel any sort of botherness there. Right? The next one is N. N is used before a noun beginning with a vowel sound, like an orange. You see the vowel sound starts with A, E, I, O, U. Then an egg, an elephant, an R. Here, orange, egg, elephant, and R are words beginning with a vowel sound. So ultimately, you need to take care of the things. Whether the noun is starting a consonant, you'll use their O. And when it starts with the vowel sound, there you'll use N. How to use A and N? The use of A and N is determined by sound. You need to understand this. It is ultimately determined by sound. Sound determines which one is to be used. The following words begin with a vowel, but not with a vowel sound. A unique thing, a 1 rupee coin, a European, a unicorn, a university, a useful thing, a union. Like this, you need to read these students for the sake of only practice, so that you'll be able to justify the things. Now let's see use of definite articles. Definite articles we have studied so far. That is used before singular countable nouns, plural countable nouns, and uncountable nouns. In short, this da is used before every sort of noun. Uncountable nouns do not have plural forms. For example, we cannot say sugars. We will say the sugar. Right? Uncountable noun can't be made the plural. Now you see the uses of da. While talking about a particular person or thing, or one already referred to, that is when it is clear from the context, which one do we mean? Now you need to understand, student, this I told you, like when the thing is known by the speaker as well as by the listener, that becomes specific or particularized. When you are using this particularly, there it gives you sort of indication that the things are quite familiar between both, like the speaker as well as the listener, then there we use the. When you want to particularize the noun, right? When you're referring this noun, then you just go with this. The next one is, the book is the book you want is not available. Means the speaker knows as well as the listener also. This is the particular thing. The book you want is not available. When a singular noun represents the whole class. When a singular noun represents the whole class. You need to see the whole class refers to species basically. The dog is a faithful animal. A singular dog here is referring to the complete class, means uski prajati ke bare mein batata hai. Before some proper names that denote physical features, oceans and seas, rivers, you see the specific ocean, the Yamuna, canals, the Sizal, deserts like the Thar, groups of islands, the West Indies, the Netherlands. Read this properly, students, after just either you take the screenshot or just pause the video when you get it and then read them properly. These are the points where the definite article is used. Before names of religions and or mythological books. These are some of the points which help us to understand where da is used. The Vedas, the Puranas, the before the names of things which are unique, one of their kind, the sun, the moon, the Pacific Ocean, before a proper noun when it is qualified by an adjective the great Caesar, the king of Rome, the Mr. Verma, whom you met last night, is my boss. When you use like the proper noun and qualifying as an adjective, you just need to use their thought. With superlative degree, that's quite easy. This is the worst. Worst is the superlative degree that is used before it. With ordinals, I told you people, we do have numbers, cardinal and ordinal. Cardinal numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4. Ordinal numbers are 1st, 2nd, 3rd. Right? In both, you use the article before. Ordinal numbers, right? He was the first man to walk on the moon. The first one is the ordinals, ordinal number. Before musical instruments, he can play the tabla. Before an adjective, when the noun is understood. The rich always exploit the poor. Here, the word peoples is understood. That we need to understand. Now see the next one, as an adverb with comparatives. The more money we have, the more we want. When you just compare in a single sentence two things, there you can use the before both the comparatives. Right? So that's what we need to understand, how it works. Demonstrative adjectives, this, that, these, those. These adjectives are called the determiners when these are used in front of nouns. When these are used after nouns, then these are not called determiners. Remember, students, these are only determiners when these are used in front of nouns. And this, that, these, those, these are working as a determiner also. So we just need to justify how it is working here. That in case of plural those, singular is that and plural is those. It is used to avoid the repetition of the preceding nouns. The noun is going on in the sentence. It is used to stop the preceding sentence for them. My bat is better than that of my friend. Means that is used for the bat here, right? That bat. So not to use on the second time or repetition. Now you see that for the plural, that is used for singular, and for plural, those is used. Our soldiers are better equipped than those of Pakistan. Now I suppose you can understand, those is used for the soldiers. That means we didn't want to repeat the nouns, right? See the next one. It refers to person or thing far from the speaker. Far means a little away. That refers to, that is used for that. When something is a little away, for that we use that. Like, get that dog out of here. A little away. Those houses are for sale. A little away by just pointing out the finger. This, in case of plural, these. Now this, it refers to person or thing near the speaker. This refers to the near. Now how it is basically, see, this book is very interesting. Book is a noun and this is used in front of noun and this is referring to the book. This word is referring to the noun book. That's why this is used as a determiner. These flowers are very beautiful. So, and then these here is referring the flowers. And flowers is noun basically. Then these are used before in like a noun. That's why these are called determiners. Now you see the quantifiers. Quantifiers are the numbers basically. Definite and indefinite numbers, students. Now you see some, many, a lot of, and a few are examples of quantifiers. Quantifiers can be used in affirmative sentences, questions, requests, or commands with both. countable and uncountable nouns. Now what we need to see, there are some books on the desk. Now you see this sum is used in front of books. This sum is referring the books, though it is indefinite, right? This sum is determiner. He's got only a few dollars, a few efforts to sum, then dollars, referring like dollars. So it is used here as a determiner. How much money have you got? Now you see, how much money have you got? Much is used for money here, that's a quantity basically. There is a large quantity of fish in this river. The large is also referring quantity basically. Quantifiers are the quantity or counting, both efforts. He has got more friends than his sister, right? So we need to understand, students, this is basically giving the counting or quantity in front of the noun. Like some quantifiers can go only with countable nouns. Like for example, friends, people, cups. Now you need to understand, some can be used with the countable nouns and some will go with the uncountable nouns. Some can go only with uncountable nouns like sugar, tea, money, advice. While some can be used with both countable and uncountable nouns. Examples of quantifiers are given below. Only with uncountable nouns, you have got a little, a bit of, a great deal of, a large amount of. These are used for uncountable nouns, students. And the next one, with both countable and uncountable nouns, both you need to say, countable as well as uncountable. No, none, not any, some, all, any, a lot of, lots of, plenty of. These are used before countable and uncountable nouns. Now only with countable nouns, I've got a few, a number of, several, a great number of, a large number of. So you need to understand, students, like you just need to practice the determiners, how these are used before the nouns or in front of the nouns. Usage of quantifiers